Hi, welcome to Sona Motivates. Sona motivates you to eat healthy, be happy and enjoy every moment. So guys, welcome to our spice series. It's week 17. It's week 17. Coriander seeds, three amazing health benefits of this world's one of the oldest spice. And thank you very much who are joining us live right now, and thank you to all of those who watch these videos later, and make sure they share it, comment on it, and it's always pleasure to see you. So I'm going to share a very interesting fact for the start, but let me see who is here joining us online. Okay, oops, what did I do? Okay. So let's start. Okay, so regarding cilantro or coriander seed, it's always like either you love it, you love the fresh lemony fragrant smell of cilantro, you enjoy garnishing with it, or you hate it. You absolutely hate the cilantro and its coriander seeds, and you feel it's soapy and it has weird smell. And if this happens to any one of you, it's not actually the person, it's the genes. Yes, there in the year 2012, they did a study with around 30,000 people, and they found out that there is one specific gene in our olfactory senses in our brains, which gives us sense of smell. Those people who feel this cilantro has that weird smell, they actually have the genes which they are very sensitive to the aldehyde, what the organic compound present in cilantro, and this organic compound actually gives cilantro a characteristic smell. And these people are sensitive to this smell, and that's why they don't like it. But the good news is, it's not like one of those genes where, you know, if you are if you are short, then you won't, you know, be able to grow to that height which you want, or maybe bald, you won't be able to grow your hair. It's not that kind of genes. This can be altered. What happens is, if you crush cilantro, you know, you use it like paste, or maybe chutney, then you're actually, maybe your small sense of smell gets desensitized, and you are actually able to use cilantro or rather coriander seeds in your diet. So hi Ruchi, thank you for joining. So the coriander seeds are cilantro. Okay, let me show you first. So these are the seeds. Okay, these are the coriander seeds. This is how they look. They are kind of maybe oval egg shaped. They are light brown, and they have a peculiar smell as well. We use them in the whole, as a whole, as spice, or we ground them mostly with cumin. They go very well with cumin. And you can see the picture of cilantro on our screen right now, and it's a fresh herb. Indians especially, we use them, and even Mexicans, they use cilantro very extensively in their diet. Okay, but okay, if you hate cilantro, then why do you need to eat it? The most important part is you have to eat it because it fights food poisoning, and this is something very new I learned as well. Several studies have shown that coriander seeds or cilantro as an herb has a very strong antimicrobial effects against foodborne pathogens. So what happens is, it actually forms a covering, an outer covering, or maybe a protective layer inside your body, which helps you fight the food poisoning. And how does it do it? Is actually Salmonella is one of the very notorious, you know, bacteria, or it causes at more than 1 million food poisoning cases in the world. And cilantro or our coriander seeds have a very specific compound which fights Salmonella, and it is said that it is more effective than the leading antibacterial or all these medications which you find. They are more effective, twice as effective as the antibacterial medicine which is given when you have the food poisoning. So clearly that if you want to avoid food poisoning or foodborne any kind of foodborne illnesses, it's good to add cilantro because it forms that protective covering and it helps you fight the food poisoning or foodborne illnesses. So hi Nimisha, thank you for joining. Actually, I have a story of this my food poisoning case. A couple of years ago, we went to one of the restaurant. I won't give the name, but we had the sandwich and it had mayo. And little did I know that mayo actually has raw eggs in it. And oh my God, it was disaster. I never had that kind of experience. But a sandwich was really good. We had it and we did a couple of chores. It was on weekend, and after coming home, it's like everything started spinning around. The room was spinning. I was throwing up like crazy. My husband and my kids, they were so scared. We almost thought that I have to go, we have to call 911, and I thought I'll have to get admitted. But we tried at home, some home remedies and so on, and I was continuously throwing up. And that time, actually, I never knew how the people who suffer from vertigo they feel, because my husband, as a good Samaritan, started searching internet and WebMD, and everything came to the rescue. And we went, okay, there was problem in my ear and the fluid and the vertigo, and we found out n number of, especially he was trying to help me with all this, but it wasn't helping. But anyway, it was so bad till the evening. I was throwing up, and after maybe I had this in the lunch around 11, 12 o'clock, and then after 4 or 5 hours, maybe in the evening, I was a little better. But it was one of a kind of experience where I totally understand when you are having such kind of food or poisoning problem. At that time, it's very scary. We think, oh, it's just stomach upset, but it's not like that. It's actually very painful, and it was really bad for me. But so if you want to avoid this, make sure you use coriander seeds or cilantro in your diet regularly. Of course, I used it, but the sandwich didn't have any cilantro in it, and probably it didn't help me that way. Okay, so I didn't know actually about the flowers. We have seen sometimes the flowers of coriander or the cilantro on the leaf, but they are very pretty. You see on the screen, they are so pretty, and they have that mauve, or you can say a pink tinge to it. They are very cute. And then we get seeds, and we also have the herb. As an Indian, we actually use stems, roots, seeds, leaves, everything of cilantro. We love everything about cilantro, or even the coriander seeds. Now, even if it is coriander seeds, I'm going to talk a little bit about cilantro as well, because we use them in mix and match. I will always run, because back home we call it coriander, and here it's called cilantro, and we extensively use the seeds as well. Okay, and it is actually, even if it is native to Iran, it spreads so widely all around the world. It was grown. It is found in Western Asia. It's in Southern Europe, and now people from Latin America use it. Mexico uses it. North America, Middle East, everywhere cilantro is used. And I see Akansha here. Thank you for joining. I see Monica here. Thank you very much for joining. So just now we saw how cilantro or coriander seeds can help against food poisoning. Okay, so it's very, very interesting how cilantro or coriander seeds are used around the world. And in Europe, French actually flavor cheese with coriander. I'm sure it must be tasting so good, because I love cilantro. So I have that genes where I love cilantro and not hate it. It is also used in French liquor. Then Spanish use it, and we know it, because I do use when I make my Mexican rice, or even the black beans. I do use cilantro generously, or even the coriander seeds. And I think that one of their spices also have coriander seeds, ground coriander seeds. And it is very, very common in our households to use coriander and cumin powder in our curry powder. So even if you don't have the whole curry powder recipe, you can ground some, roast a little bit cumin and a little bit coriander seeds, and in the same quantity, in equal quantity, and then you You ground it and keep it and add to any dish, and especially if you like roasted cauliflower, roasted broccoli, or even potatoes. If you like to roast them, just a little salt, pepper, and add this cumin and coriander powder, and let me know how it tastes. It's amazing. So you don't need a lot of spices for cooking, but if you know exactly what and when to use it, I'm sure the food will taste good. And then it comes the curry, like I told you, the curry spice mix has it. In Java, island of Indonesia, cilantro is rubbed in on the meat. And now we know why cilantro or even the coriander seeds are used in marination of meat, poultry, or the big games, because they help you not get sick from food poisoning. Moroccans use in their couscous and stews as well. Last but not least, in Yemen, they cook mix coriander with dried fruits, green chilies, and other spices to make a condiment called, I cannot pronounce it, but it sounds interesting, which is also popular as a dip. So the spelling is J-H-O-U-G. So if any of my Moroccan friends watches this, please let me know these pronunciations. It will be very easy for me to help you guys, and we will learn a lot from you. And in Turkish, people use coriander seeds in Turkish coffee, and this is so interesting. We had no clue that coriander seeds can be used in the coffee as well. Okay, so this is how the coriander is used, the seeds are used around the world. And isn't it amazing that last week's spice was our kokum, it was used mostly, it was known to only in India, and it was used mostly in Indian province, but this coriander seeds or cilantro is used all around the world. So this spice, some have traveled all around the world and have left their imprint there, but some are still very, very, they didn't have any spotlight yet, and it's our job to spread the healthy word about the spices. Okay, now our second health benefit is it improves thyroid functions, conditions. So how does it help it? Thyroid is actually one of the gland, and it helps, it regulates the hormone balance, and it thyroid gland actually regulates the, it balances the hormones, and it helps the metabolisms and growth hormones. But if there is a problem with these glands, then there is imbalance of hormones, and people suffer from either hypothyroidism or hyperthyroidism. And cilantro has all those minerals and vitamins and antioxidants which help regulate these hormones. So actually cilantro, you can say water, or even the tea, it is called the coriander seeds tea, it is used balance the thyroid function. So we are going to see, apart from using them in cooking as spices, I'm going to share with you guys three medicinal ways how you can incorporate this coriander seeds or cilantro in your let's talk about coriander seeds, and later we will see how you can use cilantro as well. Okay, so how you can use the coriander seeds is okay, let me first see who is judging. Hi Pratibha, thank you for joining. And Nimisha has some suggestion that in summer we boil the seeds in water and drink the water to protect the body from heat. Perfect, and that's where I was heading, Nimisha, thank you very much. And that's what we are calling it, coriander seeds, is not only in summer, actually it has lot of health benefits. This coriander water has lot many health benefits. Then this, it is also it also helps weight loss, fat loss, then of course it is soothing and cooling to the body, and also people have used this to actually regulate their menstrual cycle. So if you have a heavy flow during your menstruation, your heavy bleeding, make sure you use this cilantro water. So friends, actually whenever I share some health benefits of this spice, at least pick one spice. I know it's sometimes too much. Now it's all our 17th week, and we talked about 17 spices and different uses, and sometimes it might get too crazy with all this knowledge and stuff. Pick one spice and start incorporating that spice the way you want, and maybe today's spice is cilantro or coriander seeds. Just start making the coriander water every day, keep it ready. already and drink it in the morning and evening and see for the next maybe 21 days is the best to form any habit. So see for the next month how you feel, what changes you feel. Do you feel tired? You feel less tired? And have your, you know, did this month was normal, the regular cycle, it wasn't the heavy flow, or you know, like Nimisha is telling that maybe it was you felt soothing because it's so much heat these days, especially in South Florida right now. Maybe you feel cool or calm inside. So try these and let me know how you feel, at least one remedy, and please share with us how you are, you know, coping up and how you are liking our health benefits. Okay, so actually I got a little distracted. Let's come back how in different ways you can use it. So one thing is take, I don't know whether you guys know about rock sugar. It's actually a form of crude sugar. It's not as chemically processed as the regular sugar, as the cane sugar we get. It is still in the rock form, and it, because it is less chemically processed, it might be not that white, but they say while making, a little bit milk is added to them so they can still retain the white color, but they are a little sometimes creamish in color, but they are very beneficial. And I see Anjali joining. Hi Anjali, thank you very much. Yes Nimisha, it's our 17th week. Then I also see Sumitra is joining, probably. Nice to see you. So I was talking about this rock sugar, and we call it kari sakar. Sakar is sugar and kari is like a stone. It's a small rock, and it's more beneficial. It is very extensively used in Ayurveda than the regular sugar or even honey. So what you can do is, if you can find this rock sugar online or even in Indian stores, we always get them ground one in the same, in the equal quantity, maybe one tablespoon of this coriander seeds, and one tablespoon of this, maybe a rock, it comes in a rock form, one smaller rock of this rock sugar, and keep the grounded, ground them together and keep them ready, and in the morning one teaspoon and in the evening teaspoon. You eat them before lunch, in the morning actually, and maybe before dinner in the evening or later, and drink a little bit of water on it. And this is the best way to incorporate the right amount of coriander in your diet, because it helps with so many things, not only the menstrual cycle, the thyroid, the food poisoning, the last one we are going to talk about, the digestive effect, but also it is actually seen beneficial in the maintaining the healthy blood sugar. Then it lowers the bad cholesterol, that is the LDL, and it actually increases the good cholesterol, that is the HDL. It also helps to regulate the blood sugar, and it is actually seen beneficial in actually urinary, treating UTI, urinary tract infections, and all these, you know, infections. So do try to use this in this form, so we can make the powder and keep it ready. Or okay, hi, I see Chroma. We ground seeds and used in chorizo. Oh, thank you, Chroma. This is so nice to see. Cilantro or the coriander seeds, it's so popular that Chroma didn't ask how to use it, but she actually let us know how she uses it. And thank you very much. That's so nice of you. Thank you for sharing how you guys use it. Okay, and then the coriander water, what Nimisha suggested is warm, actually boil a couple of these coriander seeds in the water. So what you can do is soak these coriander seeds overnight, and next morning boil them till they are half. The water actually reduces to half, and keep them ready and drink this water morning and evening twice a day, and you will see the difference, especially in all these thyroid problems and you know, the menstrual problems and UTI and then whatever I just now talked about. And many people actually use it for weight loss as well. I don't know how it is helpful, because it's not given anywhere. We tried to research it, but people have sweared on the benefit of weight loss for it. So last week also we talked about how it can help with the weight loss. Today also we are talking about this. So these all spices, like I said, they are not only to spice your food or give flavor, but they are actually herbs and medicines, and they're right there in your kitchen. Okay, and let's jump on to our third health benefit, and it is actually very common with all the spices, but it's still very important because we just shared about food poisoning and how you feel when it's just you are just throwing up or you are even with a little bit of discomfort of stomach. So actually coriander seeds are traditionally used in Ayurveda and back home for various digestive disorders. Like they are used for any kind of digestive complaints like loss of appetite or bloating, flatulence, then cramp like stomach upsets, even the menstruational cramps, then acidity, heartburn, indigestion, and all kinds of gastric issues. So even if you wa make this water, keep it ready and you can drink twice a day. So please try it for next 21 days and let me know how you feel. You can make this powder, keep it ready and eat it morning, evening. And the last but not least, there is one more health benefit of this. Actually, I have shared this health benefit while we were talking about the clothes. We actually warm the clothes. I told you how it can be used for in case of cough. If you have you're coughing, the dry cough, you can actually warm the clothes on your pan, make the powder, and then roast. Warm means you have to roast them, make the powder and add honey to it, and you have to lick, like the kids, if the kids are suffering from the cough, you can ask them to lick it, or you, if you are suffering, make it sure you lick it with your finger or with a spoon, and it helps you soothe so much. It helps a lot. And the same way coriander can be, because sometimes cloves can be spicy. So for kids, so what you can do is you lightly roast these seeds, powder them, and you can add them with the add the honey, and just make the kids lick it. And it helps with cough. And it said within 3 days you will feel the difference. And does anybody have anything to add? Go ahead, guys, add what kind of spices you have used so far, how it is beneficial to you, and we will be very, very excited to share more information. Okay, and we are on our last section. We saw three health benefits, and we are on our last section, and that is how you can use cilantro or coriander seeds in your diet. Okay, what you can do is add either whole or ground seeds to your stews, casseroles, marinades, vinaigrettes, or pickle dishes. So even if you get them the store-bought ones, you keep the powder ready, and then you add, and it will be a little different flavor to the same old things old condiments you are using. Okay, coarsely grind the coriander and rub it over the meat. We just saw it. Why? Not only for the flavor, but also for helping you protect against the food poisoning. Mix coriander seeds with peppercorns. That's a very great idea. You can keep the coriander seeds in the peppercorn, in the paper mill, and then you can use it whenever you use paper mill. You can have the added benefit of both the spices. Then sprinkle. I like this. Sprinkle what I told you. You keep the powder ready, and you can sprinkle on sauteed mushrooms. It's a good idea. And not only mushrooms. We just talked about roasted cauliflower. We talked about roasted broccoli, potatoes. Even it goes very well with, I think, zucchini, roasted zucchini or squash. It tastes amazing. And even to the you can add the whole seeds as well to any of the dish which you like. But I myself is not very fond of the whole if it comes in the bite. So I prefer using in the grounded form, but in the powder form. But you can definitely try it, and maybe you will like it. This was all about today's spice, coriander seeds. I see Nisha joining. So Nisha, please watch the videos and don't forget to leave the comment. If you like it, make sure you share it. If you are most of I got lot of comments and inquiries about how we can use this in the different ways, and people are getting a little confused about the spices. So guys, even if your friends are not on Facebook, ask them to go on YouTube. We have the YouTube, all these videos there on YouTube channel, and you can text or rather you can comment at any time, and I always try to answer your comments. So make sure you comment so we can always talk about which spice you want to research. Partially ground in Bhaji. Okay, that's a good idea. So Nimisha is suggesting we make the fritters with chickpea flour, and we sometimes add onions. We make them with back home, we make them with one of our veggie, but here we can make them with zucchini, we can make with potatoes. So we make different kind of fritters, and she says that we can add this to the in a partially grounded form to the fritters, and it tastes good. Yes, and the fritters they taste good as well. So this was all about it, and there is some suspense and some surprise coming in maybe next or next week, in couple of weeks down the road. I am going to start a challenge about how to be healthy, because this even if it is spicy, it is not only about spices, but maintaining your weight and keeping everything all together, organizing your life. And this is whatever I have learned over the years, I would like to share with you guys. And I get a lot of comments asking about my personal life as well. People are interested, who am I, how many kids I have, and feel free to ask any questions. So today I'm starting with, yes, I'm very passionate about food and nutrition. I'm a computer engineer from India back home, but I love food and nutrition. So I took a degree as a dietitian at the in the dietetics field, and now I have a food company where we make healthy food products, and we are in lot many American here in the stores, all the organic health food stores. Our products are there, we represent them. Then this is all about me, this is what I do for a living, and these Sona Motivates is my passion. It's me to help you guys get better, feel healthy. And this platform Sona Motivates is to actually share what I have learned, but not every time it was right. Sometimes I screwed up, and that's what I'm sharing, how I made mistakes and how I learned from what I was doing. So you guys, if you keep asking questions, and if you have something to share with me, please feel to share, because this platform is to join hands together and get healthier and better. And if you're watching this, make sure you share your story. Sometimes it's your passion. If you are in some kind of business, let me know about it. I will give you a shout out, like I gave to the Ministry of Curry last time. And her book is launched. I'm so proud of my friend. She's my friend from back home, and that kind of stuff. So please keep in contact. Let's make friends and share a lot about you. And I think, as usual, I'm a little bit over time, because when I talk, I get so involved with you all that I can't stop myself. But please share about your stories and about everything about you, and I'll keep sharing about me. So next week I'll talk about my kids and my husband, what they do, and from there I'll tell what is my daily health regime, what I do for exercise, what I eat, what kind of stuff I work on to keep myself spiritually uplifted, and all the good stuff. So keep in touch, and it's not about just about the spice series, it's about me. It's like Sona Motivates. So just be happy, keep healthy, and keep in touch. Okay, thank you very much for joining in today, and see you next week with a new spice and a lot of new information. And I'm sure you guys will keep posting about yourself. Thank you. Bye. Have a nice, nice, nice night. Bye.